Are you worried because you have had dreams of drinking alcohol? Well, today guys, in this video, we're going to explore alcohol dreams and exactly what they mean. We're gonna look at alcohol's effects on sleep, why dreams become more vivid, and I'm gonna share a few personal experiences with you guys. So by the end of this video, you're gonna understand that dreams of alcohol are totally normal and they are nothing at all to worry about. Stay tuned. And guys, if you do want to get access to a totally free video training showing you how to stop drinking without AA, willpower, or rehab, then make sure to click the link in the description. So guys, before we dive into talking about dreams of drinking alcohol, let's look at alcohol and sleep. It's important to grasp this. Most drinkers believe that alcohol improves the quality of their sleep. But does it really? Well, alcohol does help reduce something called sleep onset latency, or the time that it takes to fall asleep at night. However, as drinkers build tolerances, the sedative effects of alcohol start to wear off. In other words, as time goes on, a drinker needs to drink more and more alcohol to fall asleep at night. So if a drinker has a regular nightcap, it becomes less and less effective over time, unless they increase their intake. During the first half of the night, when alcohol is still being metabolized by the body, people spend more time in deep sleep and less time in REM sleep. That being said, more time in deep sleep is not necessarily a good thing. Changing the natural nature of sleep is generally a bad idea. This was confirmed in a 2013 review of 27 studies. REM sleep, the type of sleep that gets bypassed, is responsible for learning, memory, and mood. If REM sleep is disrupted, it can lead to reduced coping skills, migraines, and even increasing body weight. During the second half of the night, the body undergoes a rebound effect. The drinker goes from deep sleep to light sleep. Light sleep can often have more awakenings throughout the night. The drinkers might not even be aware of these awakenings, but it causes interruptions in the quality of the sleep. Alcohol also impacts sleep in a number of other ways. Alcohol contributes to sleep apnea and snoring, an increase in bathroom visits, increased risk of sleepwalking and sleep eating, and it can even trigger new sleep disorders, including insomnia. There's no denying that drinking alcohol can make you fall asleep faster. In fact, a huge 20% of adult Americans use alcohol to help them fall asleep. But much to their dismay, it has an adverse effect. Sleeping with alcohol in your system also affects something called the circadian rhythm. Your circadian rhythm is an internal process that regulates the sleep-wake cycle. It repeats roughly every 24 hours. Now, alcohol disrupts this cycle, and the effects of disrupting your circadian rhythm can be widespread, meaning that it doesn't just affect sleep. Disrupting your circadian rhythm can also affect liver functioning, your gut, depression, and more. The fact of the matter is that drinking alcohol does not improve sleep. It has the complete opposite effect. It destroys people's abilities to have a good night of rest. Even if the drinker has a few drinks and doesn't have a hangover, there will be higher levels of fatigue, an inability to concentrate, and increased irritability. Next, guys, let's look at what happens when you stop drinking. Through speaking with hundreds of ex-drinkers, sleep improvements are one of the biggest benefits mentioned. People say things like, "I've forgotten what a good night of rest feels like." Now, for some people, it may take a few weeks, sometimes even months, until they actually start sleeping better. But eventually, they do. However, many drinkers experience vivid dreams shortly after stopping drinking. So, what about these dreams of drinking alcohol? Well, dreaming about alcohol has happened to me on numerous occasions. Each time I'd wake up, I'd be in this complete state of panic. I just dreamt about drinking alcohol and I thought that it was real. And I'd wake up and I'd feel ashamed, disappointed, and stressed. In each instance, it just took me a few minutes to realize that what I just experienced was actually a dream. And then it was like this sigh of relief. I just couldn't believe it. Now, some people experience these dreams and they worry that something is wrong with them. Well, there are two things at play here. The first thing is that you are sleeping better. Your brain is going into REM sleep when it is supposed to, so you were dreaming more. And the second thing is that you were dreaming about something that has been a part of your life for years. There are parts of your brain that will just not understand what exactly is going on. So, naturally, you're going to dream about alcohol. So what should you do about dreaming about alcohol? Now, I'm not gonna lie, some people do find these dreams stressful. However, when you wake up, you can use this as an opportunity to remind yourself that you are free. You can remind yourself that you're finally free of the alcohol trap that you've just dreamed of. You can remind yourself that these dreams have nothing to do with your subconscious mind telling you that you still want to drink. It is not true. It is absolutely nothing to worry about whatsoever. It's a totally unexplainable phenomenon that happens to almost all people that have given up drinking. It's happened to me, it might have happened to you, and it's happened to thousands of other ex-drinkers. When you can finally understand that alcohol gives you absolutely nothing, use these dreams as an opportunity to celebrate your newfound freedom. And guys, if you click the videos on the screen now, you can learn more about the four stages of stopping drinking and also four surprising truths of giving up alcohol. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks a lot.